over here, mate. Every rehearsal. Come on. Start again. I need the light. Jesus, it's the fourth performance. I can't believe you guys are right. Amateurs! Just put a light on me, please. Thank you. Yeah, that works out. Hello, boys and girls.
Hello.
Bit better than that. Hello, boys and girls.
Hello.
That's better. I am Fairy Duckdown, and welcome to this year's offering of Southery Pantomime, Mother Goose.
One of you. How dare you come here to enjoy your evening? Well, I'm sure mine and Martin's acting will put pay to that. Oh, hello, who are you?
I am Fairy Duckdown. You aren't messing with the wrong fairy here.
Ah, try me, I'm as evil can be.
Oh, whatever.
Anyway, I wish I had more time to stand here talking to you, because you are just so cute when you're in.
I am not cute!
See you later, boys and girls.
Yeah, him. He's just so infuriating. It's made me forget all my lines. I've been practicing since September, you know. Where was I? Oh yeah, welcome back to Southery's Pantomime, where this year we focus on Mother Goosey, who lives in Ferrybank with her son, Brucey. Yeah, I know. I don't know why she named him that either. Anyway, we catch up with Mother Goosey, as she's on a trip to Upgate Street stores and meets a surprising character.
Bye. What a beautiful morning it is. A beautiful morning to start collecting taxes. Because I'm the tax man. If you drive a car, I'll tax the street. If you want to walk, I'll tax your feet. If you're feeling cold, I'll tax the heat. If you want to sit, I'll tax your seat. I'm a tax man and you're working for no one but me. Hello there, Mother Goose.
Hello, Squire.
And where are you off for this fine morning?
Well, me and Brucey are off to the old shop to find something for our Sunday dinner, aren't we, Brucey?
Brucey!
Keeper.
You did. I am sorry about that. I just saw Lucy to Squire's daughter and she did me looking beautiful today.
I don't think you ever make a suitable match for my daughter.
Why on earth not?
Because you can barely afford to pay your taxes. Talking of which, today's taxes day, so come on, cough up.
But I've just given the last money to the old Southery superheroes. They're doing the moonwalk. Again.
And I don't care, because you're already several weeks behind.
Oh, you have no heart. You wait till I see your wife at Wild Indians.
Wild Indians?
Yeah, you know, Women's Institute.
now let's not be too hasty.
Well, I think a little extension seems like I gave my last £10 away to charity. Anyway, I must be going.
I'll be round in 2 days and I shall expect to collect everything that you want.
Of course, Squire. Come on, Brucey, keep up.
We've got half a pint of fat pint, half a glass of half a glass.
Some people have no decorum.
Bon of the douche.
Ciao, do you speak Italian? Guys, please, and try to sell my magic cucumbers.
Magic cucumbers, you say? What makes them magic?
Do you water hot water and then they're massive?
Why would I need a massive cucumber? In that case, I will take one. Will you help me plant it?
I am already planted one. Here's one of them earlier. How about that?
My name's Brucey. Nice to see you.
See you nice!
Yeah, you know what I'm gonna say, don't you? Too quiet. Let's do it again. Nice to see you!
See you nice!
Yeah, that's good. Well. I will be coming on throughout the panto and saying nice to see you, and I want you to shout to see you nice back at me every time. So, what about this magic cucumber? And how is it magic? Only time will tell, I guess. Spike!
Brucey! Hurry up!
So I can pluck it.
It's in the pantry.
This bird looks a little on the large side.
But I know. Check out the breasts on that, mate. I tell you.
I think it's going to take me weeks to pluck it. I mean.
Oh.
not the bird you bought.
That wasn't the one I bought. How am I going to fit that in that one?
Oh! Well, I don't think you're going to, not without chopping it up. Oh!
Well, especially now getting access to this, there's no time to go through that.
Oh, no!
Oh, we can't chop it up, Mum. Can we keep it instead?
Yes.
I don't care what you say, it's not staying.
Mum, please.
Oh!
What has just done on the floor?
You make another mess on the floor without having to pick them up. But shit! Have you seen the side of that egg?
Oh.
Over there, that is ginormous. That is a 12 omelette egg if I ever saw one.
Well, I reckon old Penny here can save it.
Penny? I was thinking we'd name it something like Priscilla.
Not on your Nelly. I reckon I could have the audience.
Oh, I don't know about that, Mum. I look a bit immature, this lot. You don't get me caught up with my poo-poo head or worse.
No, honestly, what could be the worst that will happen?
Well,
right, mate. I need a name for me old Goosey.
Horse pig.
like that one. Where are you? I can see you've got it.
Chicken George.
Chicken George? It's a goose! But I do like that one because it's better than horse meat, so I now name this goose Chicken George!
Oh.
So what are we going to feed it?
My magic cucumber.
No, oh, don't be so big.
No, Mum, I bought a magic cucumber just in the last scene. You know, we should feed the goose that.
No cucumber is going to sustain this goose, is it?
Well, I'll get it, and you can see.
Oh.
Very, very 2016.
All right. It's big, isn't it?
What makes it magical then?
Well, probably the size of it, and it has this handy little tap on the end to get all the juice out of it.
Well, that shouldn't take long. It's a particularly small brain.
Hey, that's not fair. I couldn't remember the...
Nothing. Clearly.
So, what should we be telling you what we've clearly forgot?
A roundup of what the villagers have been doing this week would be nice. How else am I to plan my evil escapade if I don't know what they've been up to?
Oh, well, Scooter played the wrong field again.
So, let me get this right. He's ploughed the wrong field, sprayed his taters from ground up, and he's been standing at the school gate with a packet of sweets and a cheesy smile. For legal reasons, that last bit was not true. will he ever learn?
Tommy at the shop has started selling prime.
Prime? What on earth is prime? It's flavoured water. Don't care about flavoured water. Tell me something interesting.
I don't know what you find interesting.
Squire was collecting taxes earlier and Mother Goose didn't pay.
Ooh, why couldn't Mother Goose pay her taxes?
She gave her last £10 to Southery superheroes. Which reminds me, we should probably donate as well.
We will not donate to people who are just doing the basic human ability of putting one foot in front of the other.
But it's for charity.
I don't care.
That's a bit harsh.
I don't care. They're just walking.
That's a bit harsh.
But I do care that Mother Goose couldn't pay her taxes. So usually she's so nice, so ooh, happy da da da,
she is a very nice lady.
I bet I can sell her bag.
I don't know, she's just too nice.
Work with me. Right. We could. No, we couldn't, not yet. If you was bad, if you was nice, what would make you bad?
I don't know, we're already bad.
We could put beer prices up. Thanks, everyone. But then, no, we'll scrap that one. That means I'd have to pay more too.
We could dye her hair a horrible colour.
Murder her whole family.
It's a bit harsh. This is a family show, you know.
Sorry, too many Netflix true crime mysteries.
We could make her...
You do no such thing.
How did you get down here?
Oh, my fairy magic lets me go wherever I want to, so I thought I'd come and ruin your day.
Ooh, and who is that?
This is Minnie Fairy. She's in training. She just passed me a very important message.
Well, isn't that nice? You can't do your own job, so you have to get a little munchkin to do it for you. You know what's is over that way, don't you?
Very funny. Anyway, I thought I'd just come down here and tell you you'll never succeed in your stupid plan to make Mother Goose mad, because I will stop you.
Not sure what a little fairy like you's going to do about that.
My magic is far more superior than yours.
Oh, no, it isn't.
Oh, yes, it is.
Oh, no, it isn't.
Oh, yes, it is.
Oh, no, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
I feel like I need to lighten the mood a little bit now. Who's up for some jokes? Anyone? Yeah. Let's see. What do you call a fly without any wings? A walk. What else? Ah, my neighbour the other day. She was getting really upset. All her clothes kept going missing off the washing line. She called the police round, they'd done a full investigation. When they knocked on my door, I nearly crapped her pants. Oh, thank you, thank you.
Sweetheart, I'm in a bit of a hurry.
Not too much of a hurry that you can't stop and talk to your wife and daughter, I should hope, darling.
No, of course not, dear.
And when you look at the state of your clothes, when you're out and about, you're representing this family, and I will not have people laughing at the state of your clothes.
Sorry, dear.
And how is the tax collecting going?
Not very well. They all seem to have an excuse.
I think you're a bit too soft for this job, don't you?
Well, if you remember, it wasn't my first choice of job.
Oh, well, I simply wasn't going to have you being a police officer. It's a very dangerous job and for very little pay. And I wasn't going to stay at home all day and all night looking after a daughter all by myself. You needed a more family-orientated job.
Well, I'm miserable doing it. Nobody likes me. All I do is take money from them.
It's not a popularity contest, you know.
Oh, hi Lucy. You're looking lovely today.
Hi Gracie, how are you today?
Not so bad, Mum just sent me out for a job. Oh. So I'm looking for anyone that's hiring.
That's exciting.
Not so much, haven't been very successful, you see.
Oh, that's disappointing.
Yeah. Mum will kill me if I don't get a job though, because now we have a massive goose to feed.
A massive goose?
Oh, Lucy, come along, I've told you not to fraternise with him. And you, come.
Hello everyone, nice to see you!
See you guys!
Well, I'm just out looking for a job. Mum sent me out for one because I can't afford to keep the goose if I don't have a job. Even though I just seem to keep drinking magic cucumber juice, but that'll surely shrivel up soon. Anyway, I can't stop and chat today, I must go.
Butcher.
You know,
I'm half gonna
think. Maybe not. Okay, easy, yeah. Ouch. I really wish I could get a job, boys and girls. Maybe if it wasn't in the pantomime, I'd have a better chance. You know, I've always wanted to be a chef. I just really love cooking. If I was not in pantomime, something else I'd rather be. If I was not in pantomime, a top chef I would be. You'd hear me all day long, singing out the song. Drop the carrot, the stew, stretch and pull the pastry. Drop the carrot, the stew, stretch and pull the pastry. If I were not in pantomime,
boys and girls, I bet you're wondering where I've got to.
We're late! We're not on the pantomime!
Are we late? We've come for the panto. I'm always late.
I'd say you're about 4 seats too late, actually.
Darn it.
And I also don't know why you're here. I'm the narrator this year.
No. Actually, I'm the narrator.
No,
I am.
And look, the spotlight's on me.
Get out of my spotlight. This is it. It's enough. I'm the narrator this year, and I will have order. I was about to tell the people that we've heard the demon's horrible plan, and I was going to tell them my plan to stop him. And then you lot came bumbling in. What even are you anyway? I'd say cherubs, but you're all far too old.
There's the old, you cheeky so-and-so. Yeah. You're only as old as you feel.
Yeah, and I feel 21.
You are aware that cherubs are supposed to be babies, right? Unless you've all got a case of the Benjamin Buttons, which I highly doubt.
No!
Oh, damn, she's found us.
Yes, I found her, and I have to get back to her medication.
You have to catch us first.
Great, if you could just round them up, that'd be grand. I'd get on with telling my story.
Honey, she was crying.
Not very hard.
Get away.
Firstly, you do it then, if you're so great. Us NHS are other staff underpaid and here
you go. That's old you!
Secondly, I don't know if you've noticed, but sloths move faster than they do.
Listen, I just need to get on with telling my story.
Can we help?
Yeah, we're really good at helping get rid of evil.
Yeah. We managed to get scurried out of the power on the Saturday
night. I'm not sure that I need your help.
Oh, please!
Absolutely not. The only help they need to get the best at home, and if you would help, this means this order can get to the bar at the break.
The bar?
And Mary can go and tell you the story.
Right, you heard her. She said bar. Off.
Well,
I'm off. Medication time!
I tell you, at least one of you needs changing. Yes, dear.
Mum.
What is so urgent?
The goose is laying golden eggs.
Don't be silly. What have I told you? Nothing lays golden eggs.
Look.
It's gold!
I told you. I've got a golden egg. I've got a golden egg to pay the rent. I've got a golden egg and it will be, well, spent.
Will you stop singing? Do you reckon that could have been that cucumber?
Must have been. She stayed like 10.
10? 10? It was hiding my way. Same for a rainy day.
You want to save him up?
Yes, it's a responsible thing to do. We can live comfortably and we can help other people too.
Oh, you're so kind, Mother.
Oh no, anybody would do the same.
I'm sure they couldn't.
Now go and get the eggs. Hidden.
Where are they?
Thank you.
to?
Nowhere. Move for consciousness. Woo!
So why are you here then?
To make sure that you make the right choices in life. Or to make sure that you make the wrong choices in life.
So why have I not seen you before?
You've not been in a turmoil before.
And who's to say I'm in turmoil now?
You're about to be.
I didn't think spoilers were allowed in pantos.
Oh, this isn't a spoiler. Well, it kind of is.
It's not.
It's too. We've just told the audience that the main character's going to face turmoil.
No, you've just told the audience that the main character's going to face turmoil.
And you've just confirmed that, ha,
you're insufferable. You know that.
I don't know whether to wear this or frost with it.
You said mommy's sick. No! Don't make me look fat, that will!
You already is fat!
Thank you! Someone greet him!
No, it won't, but you can't make your eyes pop.
I didn't do more than that, actually. Don't you think it'd make my bum look big?
Your bum will look huge!
I'm beginning to take a dislike to you.
That is the point. I am the devil after all.
You look lovely in whatever you wear.
You have such a brown nose, though, you know that.
Oh, you don't like the balloons,
though,
do you?
Oh, no,
I'm oh, you don't?
Yeah.
Good. Enough! Well, I'm going out. I don't know if you're coming with me. See you in a bit.
Told me that one of you told him that Amaranth or Tongs had said that Mother Goose has got golden eggs.
Wasn't me. Sorry, can you repeat that? I got completely lost halfway through.
Right, listen. That demon told me that one of you told him that Amaranth or Tongs had said that Mother Goose has got golden eggs.
Mother Goose has golden eggs?
That's what I've been told.
Yeah, but by who?
Oh, you're right. I'm not an owl. Mother Goose has got golden eggs and we need to get hold of that bird.
But how? I've seen that woman and she scares me.
I don't know, but it seems like a big risk.
No, it'll be easy. Tonight, while she's at Zumba, we'll sneak in, grab that giant chicken, drag it out of the house, and then I'll have all the golden eggs and I can evict her and her idiot son.
Goose are way scarier than chickens, especially giant ones.
You two know better than mine. Emma, Tonks, get out of here.
Yes, Your Evenness.
Take these two ifties and make fun of Mother Goose and Zonda tonight. That way, when she comes out, I will be waiting to tell her there is a way to be pretty. For a price, of course.
I'll tell you what, I'm going to head back of here. My insides are going to be out soon, I think.
She's going to blow!
Pack it in! Only 5 more minutes and we're done.
5? Oh God!
5 minutes, someone call an ambulance.
Warts and all.
Here comes the little one. Here to spread more lies to the audience, are you?
Oh, will you just shut up? You're boring. Talk to the hand because the face ain't the same.
And you?
I'll leave her alone. She shut you right down, didn't she?
Shut me down all you like. I've made a deal with Mother Goose that she's meeting me at the Pool of Youth tonight.
Well, that's what you think.
What? What do you mean? I know she made a deal with me. She's going to swap that golden egg-laying goose for beauty.
What? How? No, she wouldn't do that.
You heard me. For some people, beauty is the most important thing.
Well, clearly not you. Do you steal the souls of those you take to the beauty pool at night?
How very dare you! Shut up, you old man.
Anything. Time to sort my life out.
See, I told you, it's massive.
It is. I think I've ever seen one so big.
When you sat on it, I thought it was going to burst. I just met Felicia at the market, been showing her my magic cucumber.
Much less now.
Sorry, who are you and how did you get into our house?
It's me, Brucey, it's Mama G. I met this wonderful man, I suppose, after Zumba, and he took me to a magical pool to make me beautiful.
Yeah, right, my mother a woman.
Okay, when you were a boy, well, a little baby actually, the doctors had to triple check that you were a boy because your bits
were so... Oh, is it? Yeah, no. We don't need to hear that.
Alright, so how else can I prove it? Okay, you have a birthmark, the shape of a love heart on your left butt cheek.
Yep, okay, it is you. So, how come this mysterious stranger helped you then?
Well, I had to pay him, of course. So I had to give him Chicken George.
What? Mum, how could you? And how are we going to pay the rent now?
Well, I'm sure with my new body and my looks, I should be able to earn some money, somehow. I mean, modelling or something, get your minds out the gutter.
Don't be upset, Brucey. You can't blame Mama G for wanting to be beautiful. Besides, you managed about Chicken George before. I'm sure you can manage now.
But that's not the point. Chicken George is only laying those golden eggs because we are feeding of my magic cucumber juice. Even I hadn't gotten onto that. And what if this stranger isn't feeding her properly? And what if he comes back looking for you? Anytime.
And then we'll come up with a plan, shall we?
Okay.
Yeah. Oh.
My plan is working, as you can see. There's not a fairy smarter than me. The demon won't get his wicked way. As golden eggs, the goose won't lay. Without the magic cucumber juice, it turns out to be just a regular goose.
Well, hang on a minute. Wasn't that the same before you got involved?
Yeah, exactly. What have you done?
Hello?
Would it have made a difference if you'd have stayed home?
Look. There isn't a panto without a panto fairy explaining the story to those at the back. And besides, I'm right and you're all wrong, so...
Maybe we should have stayed at home. Look who's coming. Oh no, not again. Oh.
I haven't seen a tiny baby. You're very big.
He's supposed to be young, fit and healthy. Leave fairy to go on with the job.
Yeah, what she says. Now on. The lot of you, go. Get. On.
Come on.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
Wait, something's happening.
What is it?
Golden egg soon, I'm going to see Mother Goosey, tell her where it is, she can come and find it, and the demon will never know.
You dare to undermine me? I have half a mind to get rid of you right now! And as for you, you stupid goose, you will lay me some golden eggs, or so help me, I'll chop off your head, remove your giblets, and chuck you in the oven!
Well, that demon had one thing right. He's only got half a mind. And one eye.
I still can't see what you've done here, except come out and fill everybody with sarcastic comments.
Why don't you just tell us our plan so we'll know?
Yeah.
Well, if you must
know. Then we can stop teasing you.
Well, if you must know, I couldn't stop the demon from taking the goose, because that's just not how pantomime works. So instead, I made it so that the goose would only lay golden eggs if it had been sucking on Bruce's cucumber. And anyway, Mother Goose is about to realise that being rich and beautiful isn't everything, but having a happy life is the best way to go. And then I'll simply wave my magic wand in the gayest way I can. And everything will go back to normal. I'll fix everything.
Oh, well, it makes sense now.
Yes.
I see
it
now.
Yeah, why didn't you just tell us?
Because there's no spoilers in Panto.
Except this one.
Get off. Does anyone want to hear any more jokes?
Yeah.
No, cheers, Bev. What have we got? What's the difference between a priest and Woody from Toy Story? When a kid walks in, Woody goes limp. Got a little limerick for you. Got a little limerick for you. Charlotte had a little skirt with slits right up the sides. And every time that she went out, the boys all saw her thighs. Charlotte had another skirt with a slit right up the front. She didn't really wear that one.
Golden eggs on a house with a pool? I don't think you're my mum at all.
I think Bruce is right. We need to find Chicken George. I'm so sad to give her away.
Oh, off you trot, babe. I'm going to find my house of my dreams. Make me happier.
I think we're going to need some help to find Chicken George.
What do you have in mind?
Not you, Dumbo. I was thinking about that cow behind your house, actually.
Daisy, she's been in the field since in Jaffa Beach the back in the day. Mum hopes she looks after her.
Do you think your mum might let us use her?
We can try. What have we got to lose?
Absolutely no way. It's just not going to happen.
But
Daisy's getting on. And I can't have her gallivanting off on a wild goose hunt.
But she might be our only chance of tracking down where Chicken George is.
Please, Mum.
Well, on the basis that I have to keep an eye on you two, and that Daisy needs regular milking, I will come with you. Besides, I've no idea where your father's got to, and we might find him along the way. Daisy?
Thank you. witch. Oh, I wish I was my normal self. I really don't mind being left on the shelf.
So there it is. I heard her say it. She'll come back out and she'll look like she did before. Not everything I say has to rhyme, you know. Now we've just got to take care of that whole horrible demon. But first, let's get Mother Goosey back to how she was.
And then go look for Chicken George.
What song should we sing to lift our spirit?
Spirits? Is this the bit where there are ghosts?
No.
I don't like ghosts.
I mean to make us feel better.
Oh, okay.
Bless them. Anyway, right. They've all got programmed, I believe. So what we're going to do is split into two. So you have me, Brucey, and the winning side.
Winning side. This is the winning side.
And then you have Brucey and Squire's wife, but on the losing side. I know that's the losing side, but my old boy can't sing that. No, Brucey's can't sing, Paul can't sing. No. Sue and Janie can sing, I've heard them. Good, good. Okay. So, have you all got programs in there on the worst of the song? Excellent. It should be on the front one. Just inside.
Got community song.
He said community like song at the bottom. Is that right? You said community song? Yep, good. Alright, all got them? Good. Only three times tonight because they've got the words. Got it? Good. So what we're going to do is we're going to get the losing side first.
The winning side.
Okay, after three. We'll now show you how to do it, won't we? After three! And I'm just going to show them, we're going to raise the roof of the hall will collapse and we'll get a new hall. Okay, then one more time, all together, after three! Then, and I'll go find accommodation for tonight as it's getting late.
Yeah, all that singing is really making me feel better.
I've nearly. My two little cherubs here actually reminding me. I believe we do have a birthday in here tonight. And they are sitting on the front row. So, and it's Jan Allen. Okay? I would always like to sing happy birthday, okay? So Jan, right? Okay, after three. Three. Ha.
Just being with you makes me feel all squidgy inside, like I have a whole orchestra playing in my heart.
What was your name?
My name was Manuel.
Right.
I know she was right, but I'm totally sad to lie.
I think this guy might need glasses, I mean. Don't be so mean. Maybe he's his mother's best asset.
A giant bark.
No! Her huge heart!
Follow me, it's just this way.
Sorry to interrupt this weird moment.
Not weird.
Yeah, it is.
Not.
Oh, yes, it is.
That's weird.
I think it's a beautiful moment.
Oh, it makes me want to be sick. You're bad.
And you're sad.
I'm not!
I'm too!
Will you two stop? You're driving me nuts! Honestly, just keep going on and on and on and on. And there's another line there, but I can't remember. I see, yeah, sorry. Why did you two at my special moment?
We're leaving you, mate.
You're leaving me? I've just got used to having you around.
Sorry, Mother, but you don't need us anymore.
But we haven't found Chicken George yet. Don't leave me this way. I can't survive. I can't stay.
When we get there, we'll have to show you what we found.
Looks like you found each other.
Oh, don't get me started. Just wait until her father finds out. He's going to be so angry, he'll soon put a stop to it.
I think I know my own mind, Mum. Anyway, Dad seems busy with new friends. I'm supposed to be the least bit bothered.
Friends? What friends? I didn't say that he could have any friends.
So, ladies and gentlemen, the penultimate moment has arrived.
Wait. That's it. What has happened?
Did I miss something? How can I be finished? There hasn't even been a wedding.
A wedding? Who's getting married?
Oh, I missed the party.
I give up. I tried. I really tried. But you were just a patient and said, here's your medication and that's me done.
Hold on a second, Nursie. I think these lot have jumped the gun a little bit. Penultimate means the second to last one, so we're not quite there yet.
Come on, Fairy, let's tell the audience what's going to happen. It's
a good idea. So the gang are about to meet the demon, the squire, and all of their little cronies as they try and work out what to do with their debunked goose. The demon's about to meet his match. As golden eggs, no, that's wrong. We'll go again. The demon's about to meet his match. A final play and the game will hatch. It's the last night, right? I've had a lot of drink. Time to set those cronies loose because they don't like their goose or something along those lines. On the next morning.
Think
he's
been taking my mates.
Wakey wakey, rise and shine. Let's go get old Chicken George back.
I'll find where my beloved husband has got to.
But I think I'll leave Daisy here. She's had enough excitement for 1 year.
Where is she anyway?
Oh, she's in a field out at the back. But she's quite happy. She's found a horse, a dragon, a camel, a crocodile, oh, and Reg the donkey to keep her company.
When Lucy and I saw the demon last night in a deleted scene, he was still trying to get Chicken George to lay a golden egg, and I think Chicken George was giving him the runaround. But I think if we go and feed Chicken George some of the magic cucumber juice, then Chicken George will lay a golden egg, and we can trap them all in the excitement.
So how are we going to trap them?
Oh, leave it up to me. I think I can deal with that demon, and his little nappies will follow on and do as I say as well.
But Mum, Dad?
Oh, don't even go there. I know that he's there, and he's got those two dunderheads with him. Wait until I get my hands on them all.
Right, let's go find Chicken George. Open up trust me, then. Shush. Oh, yeah. Am I fine? Oh, yeah. You don't have to be rich and beautiful to be rich and beautiful on the inside. The kindness of what you do for other people will always be remembered. Are you stuck in there? Oh, God. Oh, yeah, that's 1 minute. I'm very good. Anyway, we come to the end of our final night, and it has been a blast. I must admit, these last 6 months are what it feels like anyway. But obviously, the script writing and things, and obviously, since October, we've been rehearsing lots of times. We've never had a full cast until literally last Sunday, because obviously, people are obviously at work and things like that. But I think we've done together well. So, I'd first like to mention somebody who's actually stood in at really, really short notice today. One of our cherubs actually came in sick this morning, and she's done actually amazing. The magazine she was reading has actually got her lines printed in. It's not that she's a bookworm, but Gracie, you were amazing. Okay. Right, there's lots of thank yous as you can see, and there's a few actually missed off which I'll add them into anyway. Once again, we'd like to thank Susan and the Southery Hair Studio for selling the tickets. The kids and the adults would be on stage on time if it wasn't for the people in the background, and I'd like to thank Gemma and Danielle for obviously making sure the kids are supposed to be ready, shouldn't be. I've got the anybody think she was a director, wouldn't she? I've got the list. I've got to work through it, okay? Obviously, last year, Constance obviously retired from the tuneful piano. And to step into the breach is, most of you know him as the lead singer and the heart behind Martha's Wood. I think he came in with open eyes and realised he'd got to adjust to our singing. literally. And I think he's done an absolutely fantastic job. So have a big, big round of applause for Adrian Pope. Don't kiss him, no tongs. Next door to him on the stage up there is the person who's been controlling the lights. He's had, bless her, she's literally been chucked in the deep end, and she's done an absolutely fantastic job. I know the little bit at the front at the beginning with Martin, but that was actually scripted in, so don't worry, that was it. But we'd like to thank Beth Smith for the lighting. Okay. As you can see, the set is here. It doesn't get put up by itself. It does take a lot of work. And the main man behind actually making sure the doors spin round and swing and everything, because they were rubbing, and he's actually had to adjust things. It's the 8th year we've actually used them, and they're getting to the stage where they're worn out. A bit like the hall, really. But anyway, big, big thank you. Obviously, there was obviously other helpers like Kevin and Martin and a few others. But the main man behind the whole lot is Barry Rooney. Apparently, for being amazing and obviously helping with my makeup, another makeup is Claire Fletch. My alter ego! In a smoking hat, but... I know our dancing was a bit rough and a bit ready, but I think we got there in the end. And the lady that actually helped us, who actually co-wrote and directed the first part of Jack and Beatles, and that's Jess Smith. Obviously, I mentioned Danielle and Gemma earlier with the children, but we have to, for legal reasons, we have to have registered chaperones. We have three, and they are Natasha, Jodie and Claire. Obviously, things don't happen without a script. Obviously, the writers, there's a little bit of a, I don't know, glitch in the middle where the scripture is sort of stopped, but to jumped in was to add to the scripture. The same poem was Martin. Obviously, a lot of comedy and things is Martin. Rose, who's done a lot of the song, put the words into the song. On behalf of all of us, and I mean all of us, and one person in particular, I'll mention her in a minute, is a big, big thank you to Kath and Jodie for being our gentle dog brothers and making sure. Obviously, the last couple of years, Kevin has directed wherever Kevin is, but this year, the award, we actually advertised for a new director and musical director. Obviously, you all came rushing forward. The interviews went in about 2 seconds because there's nobody turned up. But to jump into the hot seat of director for a first year, I think she's done an absolutely amazing job, and she is the goose, and that is Rose Moon. These big little people here, obviously will grow into this people here. we're looking for another lady. We'll work on that.
You'll be guys are your fucking noggin.
I know.
Language!
What I'd like you to do, audience, please give a big round of applause to these amazing children who actually fantastic.
Don't forget Satch,
who's
your
cameo? Oh yes, Mr. Satch, got a bit of that. That is Satch. Absolutely not that. And also I'd like to thank the ship for the bar. Thank you very much. And the bell hangs in a minute. Thank you. And finally, on behalf of all the cast, we'd like to thank you for supporting us and coming to see us. Thank you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.